I greet you all. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. Welcome to our said Eucharist on this Sunday, Wednesday following the fourth Sunday of Lent. The Lord be with you. As we worship together, let us pray together. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. And as we worship, let us be penitent. Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, returned from the Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, where for 40 days he was tempted by the devil. Let us confess our sins, remembering before God the times when we have fallen from temptation into sin. Lord, we confess to you our selfishness and lack of love. Fill us with your Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, we confess to you our fear and failure in sharing our faith. Fill us with your Spirit. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, we confess to you our stubbornness and lack of trust. Fill us with your Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy on you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness. And keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. After a moment of silence, we will pray our collect for this day. Let us pray. Merciful Lord, you know our struggle to serve you. When sin spoils our lives and overshadows our hearts, come to our aid and turn us back to you again. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. David will come and read our first lesson.
Good morning. The first reading is Psalm 147, reading verses 13 to the end. The Lord is gracious and merciful, long-suffering and of great goodness. The Lord is loving to everyone, and his mercy is over all his creatures. All your works praise you, O Lord. Your faithful servants bless you. They tell of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your mighty power to make known to all peoples your mighty acts and the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Your kingdom is an everlasting kingdom. Your dominion endures through all ages. The Lord is sure in all his words and faithful in all his deeds. The Lord upholds all those who fall and lifts up all those who are bowed down. The eyes of all wait upon you, O Lord, and you give them their food in due season. You open wide your hand and fill all things living.
to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, now, and ever shall be, world without end. Please stand. Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory. Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus answered them, "My Father is still working, and I also am working." For this reason, the Jews were seeking all the more to kill him, because he was not only breaking the Sabbath, but was also calling God his own Father, thereby making himself equal to God. Jesus said to them, "Very truly I tell you, the Son can do nothing on his own, but only what he sees the Father doing. For whatever the Father does, the Son does likewise. The Father loves the Son and shows him all that he himself is doing, and he will show him greater works than these, so that you will be astonished. Indeed, just as the Father raises the dead and gives them life, so also the Son gives life to whomsoever he wishes. The Father judges no one, but has given all judgment to the Son, so that all may honor the Son just as they honor the Father. Anyone who does not honor the Son does not honor the Father who sent him. Very truly I tell you, anyone who hears my word and believes him who sent me has eternal life, and does not come under judgment, but has passed from death to life. Very truly I tell you, the hour is coming, and is now here, when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear will live. For just as the Father has life in himself, so he has granted the Son also to have life in himself, and he has given him authority to execute judgment, because he is the Son of Man. Do not be astonished at this, for the hour is coming when all who are in their graves will hear his voice and will come out, those who have done good to the resurrection of life, and those who have done evil to the resurrection of condemnation. I can do nothing on my own. As I hear, I judge, and my judgment is just, because I seek to do not my own will, but the will of him who sent me." This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. This is one of those mornings where it's difficult to know what exactly to say in addition to what has been shared in the Holy Gospel. For this morning we have Jesus opening himself to the people of his time. Basically a plea to take off your sunglasses, or like a horse, to take off the blinkers, to be able to look right or left, and to see not just straight ahead, to see not just what is in the head, but to see what is there in front of each of us with our eyes. The first words of John, Jesus answered them. He was answering the established church. In the Holy Gospel yesterday for the Day Eucharist, Jesus healed the man who had been waiting at the pool for, they said, 38 years. And if you remember, he had nobody to help him. So by the time he dragged himself to the pool, somebody was in before him and had been healed. Jesus didn't bother with the pool. He just healed him. And the established church came to him and said, "Who did that?" He said, "I haven't got a clue. I don't know. I was just healed." And so just to be clear, Jesus came back to him. And from that moment, the guy who had been paralyzed realized it was the Son of God who had healed him and went and told the established church. What a thing to go and tell them, because it was the Sabbath. Not only was this nuisance at it again, but he was doing it on the Sabbath, the day when thou shalt not work, thou shalt not labor. And so Jesus was answering them when they accused him of breaking the Torah by working on the Sabbath. He tried to make it so clear that he's not just any ordinary person. He's the fulfillment of the scriptures. He is the Son of God. And so when he does something, it is God working through him. And he said, "I do nothing by myself. I do it through the power of my Father." Latterly, we have it translated, he said, "Very truly," twice. The original is "Amen, Amen." And when "Amen" is repeated at the time of the life of Jesus, you're basically saying, stop everything you're doing, put down your mobile phones, switch off the TV, listen to this. He did it twice. He knew he was about to be taken into custody, go through a mockery of a trial, and die for the sins of others. But still he tried to make those with the blinkers and with the sunglasses listen and see. They didn't. The rest, as they say, is history. Jesus died for our sins, was resurrected from the dead, and lives forevermore. And so we, 2,000 years later, look back on this story. Let us look back on it with open eyes, with ears that hear, with hearts and souls that believe. Jesus answered them, and he spoke to us. May we be the ones who on Judgment Day are put on the side of those who believed. May we not be with those who were put on the side of sinners. That's why we have Lent. So that we may think, and through thinking, consider, and through consideration, and now we will pray. Let us pray. Dear loving Heavenly Father, we thank you for the example of your Son, our Saviour. We pray that we may hear his words. We may understand what he is telling us. And we may respond with love and service. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Dear loving Heavenly Father, as we journey through Lent, may we use this period as a time for reflection and for self-examination. May we seek to be open to your word. May we seek to share your word. May we seek to be holy. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And now we pray for our parish and for the mission of our church. We pray for all of those who live in our parish, for those who are beginning the period of Ramadan, We pray that peace may be upon them. For those of us who follow Lent, we pray that peace may be on us. For those of other faiths and none, we pray that your peace may touch their hearts. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And now we pray for those who we know and love, for whom we know times are difficult at present. Some are known only to us, and in the silence of our prayers, we commend them that they may feel that they are not alone and your Holy Spirit is with them. From our parish list, we continue to pray for George and Nadine Baldwin, for Eddie Morris, for L. Coleman, for John Frith, for Angela and Ian Kidd, Doris Lubin, Graham Mitchell, Hilary King, Andre Campbell, John Beard, Lucy Cuthbert, and Alexa. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Finally, in these prayers, we remember those who are no longer with us, but who we have had the privilege to share love with and to share our lives with. We give you thanks for their example, and we pray that their rest with you may be eternal. We pray for the immortal soul of Robbie Rudrum, whose funeral will be held in this church on Friday morning. We pray for Robin and Heather, her children, and for all the family and friends at this time of sadness. From our memorial book, we remember by name and give thanks for the lives of Arthur William Barker, Frank Joseph Pawley, Richard Arthur Rogers, Daniel John Ashton, Marie Louise Hughes, Ronald Hugh Carden, and Edward Fraser Norris. May they rest in peace and rise in glory. Now we gather together all of our prayers, the prayers of our hearts and these spoken prayers, as we pray together. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Since we are justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us access to his grace. The peace of the Lord be always with you, and also with you. I wave to you a silent peace. Peace be with you. And for those following from home, peace be with you also from those of us here at All Saints. We prepare the table for the Eucharist. The Lord is here. His Spirit is with us. Lift up your hearts. Let's give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. It is indeed right and good to give you thanks and praise, Almighty God and Everlasting Father, through Jesus Christ, your Son. For in these 40 days you lead us into the desert of repentance, that through a pilgrimage of prayer and discipline, we may grow in grace and learn to be your people once again. Through fasting, prayer, and acts of service, you bring us back to your generous heart. Through study of your holy word, you open our eyes to your presence in the world and free our hands to welcome others into the radiant splendor of your love. As we prepare to celebrate the Easter feast with joyful hearts and minds, we bless you for your mercy, and we join with saints and angels forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Accept our praises, Heavenly Father, through your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And as we follow his example and obey his command, grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us his body and his blood. Who, in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. It's my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for others for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance. Therefore, Heavenly Father, we remember his offering of himself made once for all upon the cross. We proclaim his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. We look for the coming of your kingdom. And with this bread and this cup, we make the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Lord. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Accept through him, our great high priest, this our sacrifice of thanks and praise. And as we eat and drink these holy gifts in the presence of your divine majesty, renew us with your spirit, inspire us with your love, and unite us in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honor and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen. And now let us pray with confidence as our Savior has taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. The body and blood of Christ our Lord. Let us pray. Lord God, whose blessed Son, our Saviour, gave his back to the smiters and did not hide his face from shame, give us grace to endure the sufferings of this present time with sure confidence in the glory that shall be revealed. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We pray together. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. And now may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, be with those of you who are here and with those who you love, wherever they may be, today and always. Amen. Thank you for being here. I think only two notices, apart from the invitation for coffee and biscuits, if you're not ringing bells in the tower. Good to see bell ringers here, and it gives me the chance. Whenever you're here, I say the thanks that we feel all the time. Thank you for your service. So, the two notices. First is, yes, it's still here despite what I said last week. The latest word is next Monday, we promise. So, we have to put up with it for a little longer. That's the bad news. The good news is, we have all the papers to submit our faculty application for the passageway and the improvements to the toilet and the step-free access and lift. We're going to do it in two phases. So if I get free time this afternoon, I will be uploading all of the documents and we'll formally submit our application to the diocese. That's hoping and praying that the planning committee will approve later this month in Harrow Council. And then we're working on the final details for the kitchen and pointing to the old vestry, the new archway through, and the meeting area here. As soon as we have sufficient details, we will submit the application. The reason we're doing it in two bits is we think this is more likely to excite comments from the Butterfield Society, the Victorian Society, and Historic Churches Trust. That's my hope and prayer anyway. And so hopefully we may be able to get the passageway done before the autumn. Let's pray about that. But let's hope, let's pray, and let's do our best. So that's that. The last thing is that we're having a mammoth tidy out in the office block in preparation for the toilets, the heating in there and things like that. We found a lot of things which have just historic and have gone out because they're of no value to anybody. There are some things that we call too good to waste or too good to throw out. There's a table in front of the jigsaws. If there's anything you'd like to take, please do. If you want to give a donation, please do that. But most importantly, if you've got a use for them, please take them. Anything that's left after today, we're going to take to the St. Luke's Hospice Shop. That's enough for me. Go in peace, love, and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ.